good news for the people of Guam. Good news for the taxpayers that have been owed refunds for many, many years. The first part in the process of getting the people their money back has now been accomplished. I have a caveat there. I would have wished and hoped that the original legislation, as we had introduced, would have moved forward.
The governor's original bond bill would have paid out all past due tax refunds and would have even funded the payment of tax refunds for 2011. However, lawmakers substituted his bill for a scaled-down version that will pay out all refunds for the year 2009 and prior, and some of 2010. Lawmakers were concerned with GovGuam's debt limit or debt ceiling and thus passed a bill that does not raise the debt ceiling past the 90% that it is currently at. GITA Business Development and Marketing Manager Lester Carlson Jr. says they have already calculated how much this will allow them to borrow.
By December 1st of this year, we will have $244 million at the 90% ceiling.
Carlson says the net proceeds from the bond will then be around $211 million. Out of this $211 million, $20 million will go to COLA, and $26.4 million will go to the GovGuam Retirement Fund. To pay out the rest of the tax refunds, the governor can borrow again, but he'll have to have an independent analysis of the government's ability to borrow, and will have to convene the Deficit Reduction Commission first. In fact, the administration said they are still working on government reorganization, which still means the possibility of some layoffs. The governor says that this bill should allow them to get out the tax refunds before Christmas. While this is good news for those waiting for tax refunds, Senator Ben Pangilinan, who voted yes on the bill, is still concerned about the government's ability to keep up with tax refunds in the future.
Our work's not finished here. We'll still have some leftover past due refunds for year 2010. But what's even more critical to me is, what are we going to do going forward? I was very disturbed by the comment by the governor's chief fiscal policy officer when I asked her directly. The governor said, this is the revenue. We've set aside $105 million. Is he going to pay $105 million in FY 2012? And she's commented that, well, you know, we don't know. We don't know how we're going to do it. And to me, that is a sign for some worry to begin on my part and for some dedicated effort to make sure that happens and trying to find a process and a system to put in place to make sure it does.